Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Got past the water locks, so I was checking the place out. There's a boat tucked away underneath the tarpaulin cover. Visual calculus says, great news, the boat is big enough for a grown man like you to fit underneath it in a supine position. Wait, what would I be doing under there? I don't know, sleeping? What do people do under boats? This is merely a measurement from your visual cortex. Do with it what you want. Great news, I found somewhere new to sleep. Huh? I can pretty much finish the case from under that boat there. It's dry, weatherproof, and free of charge. Sarcastic self-pity is not what we need at this moment, officer, Kim says. I understand the situation looks grim, but we must continue with our investigation. Logic says you have a home, somewhere. All cops do. When this is done, you can return. Can I sleep there? It's not selectable like the bed is, but maybe it's too soon for that. I'm gonna look in the window, I guess? Plenty of stuff to check out, I love it. Through the broken glass, dusty shelves, and a forgotten chair. What's in here? Plastic chair, okay. You see a dark red chair in the dim light of the room. A bow knot. And a postcard. Coal City 08. Interesting. You're sure that wearing this tie is a statement? You're not very sure what kind of statement, though. It says plus one drama for theater kit. It goes where... Okay, so we got plus two drama or plus one inland empire. Yeah, I guess we'll wear that. Drama's always handy, right? Drama, always drama. Up to seven now. Lie and detect lies. I can lie and discern when others lie. Good to know. And what else? We got an item. We got this postcard. This postcard depicts a forest of smokestacks releasing fat plumes of smoke into blue cloudless sky. The tinge of age, the color of old teeth, gives it a sickly look. Written on the back is a single sentence, repeated twice. I got out. I got out. No addressee. Okay. Little shack in the middle of nowhere. Well, sort of. I think I've been over here. Yeah, we can't go that way. We've been in this yard. Can I go up these stairs here? Let's see. Let me look. We can just walk over here. Oh. Oh, we don't need to go up the stairs. I see. Oh. Wait, what? Sounds of life in the north. A washboard scrums filth from fabric. Cinder blocks, charred. A makeshift fire pit with magazines for lighting. That's just life, friend. There's people here. The bushes are too thick and thorny to pass through. This is the bench, I think, on which we just passed time. The worn and beaten wooden planks of the bench do not look overly comforting. Hmm. The lieutenant looks down the street. You can sit on benches after we solve the murder. Let's go. Agreed. Allez-vous-en. White curtains have been drawn shut. No looking in. What's this then? Excuse me, Kim, you're in the way. Intersolary trousers, +2 to Kingdom of Conscience. You see dust-covered linens, dried tulips on a bed. Tailored trousers in light brown, moderate in every aspect. They're absolutely unremarkable. In other words, perfect. Moralist pants. What kind of pants are we wearing now? +1 electrochemistry, -1 savoir faire. This gives +1 to Kingdom of Conscience. What is Kingdom of Conscience? Is that even here? I don't see Kingdom of Conscience. I guess that's one of the thoughts. Thought thing. Wait, no. It's here. Yeah, I don't know. We don't have that yet. If I put these on, well, we still have to research it, I'm sure. Does it change our research time? No. I'm not sure. Talk to those people in a minute. A wedding stone, well worn and covered in rust. Down, rock! Ceram. Construction material. Whoever planned to build this house left in a hurry. 65 real. So we're in the fisherman town now, I'm sure. The street sign is illegible below the graffito. Hard to see the details. The colors, all warm and welcoming, are cozy, though. Rock. Rocky liquor hurricane. A flower trough where nothing really grows, maybe in spring. Alright, before I start opening doors, let's talk to the people around here, these kids. Lilienne's twin? Okay, who's Lilienne? What's the twin's name? The scruffy-haired little boy kicks a stone. He can't be more than 5 years old. The other one, Lillian's other twin? Wait a second. Which one's Lilienne, then? Neither of them are Lilienne, and yet both are. The other one looks indistinguishable from him. He watches his brother kick the stone with his tongue lolling out of his mouth. Hey, where's your mom? The kids don't reply, absorbed in their little game. You guys look identical. The stone-kicking one becomes frantic all of a sudden, as if that's something to be scared of. The obvious fact that you just stated. He looks just like me, the other one says. Yeah, I said that. The boy doesn't answer. His brother throws another rock. Both of their hair is covered in some kind of dirt. You're bad with kids, the lieutenant remarks with evident glee. And what are you, Kid Master General? Maybe I am, he grins. Now, how about some actual police work? We're not getting anything out of here. Bye, kids. Take care. All right. This lady doesn't seem to speak English, but we might as well give it a try. Hello? The woman next to a bucket of clothes hums an odd melody. Her eyes are closed. Encyclopedia says you're not sure about the melody, but it might be South Samaran, possibly Sigarian, also known as the apricot suzerain tea.
Welcome to the fishing village. Please lean in closer. I have cataracts.
She opens her eyes. If you can't see, then how'd you know I was here?
I still have a golden ear. Come, come.
She beckons you toward her. All right, lean forward.
Oh, welcome, police officer. We don't cause any trouble around here, and we don't want any trouble either.
A shadow passes over her face.
We are not here to cause any trouble, madame.
Click, click, bang, bang. What he said. We're cops. We don't cause trouble. We take care of trouble.
Oh, of course. Last time we saw you around here was 12 years ago. You also came to take care of trouble then. Wish you did. But still, in Martinez, you're considered an ill omen.
Wait, I've been here before?
No, not you personally. I meant the RCM. Some of the men got into a fight. One of them killed another. Locked himself in that woodshed over there.
She points to the building behind her.
He was brooding, needed some help opening the door. You got it open for him and took him to think about what he'd done in a more secluded place. Somewhere more quiet.
I'm guessing a jail cell? She says it as if he was on some kind of spiritual retreat, conceptualization says. What kind of ill omen are we talking about?
Oh, the usual. Dark tidings. Black hound.
Wonderful. Inland Empire says, that's you, all right. A black hound licking your own heels. If I'm considered an ill omen, why hasn't anyone told me that?
Maybe we are afraid.
Why?
Because you're an ill omen.
Right.
But you're still welcome here, as long as men with guns aren't chasing you. And maybe even then, because that's the kind of fishing village we've built. I'm sorry there's not a lot of room to park your motor carriage. And not a lot of houses. Or a lot of people. My kids are long gone, searching for treasure. So are others.
Well, we don't need to worry about a place to park our motor carriage. It's already parked, permanently, pretty much.
Ah, look at me rambling. What brings you to us?
She waves her hand. What is in this fishing village? Just us. She sounds tired. We're barely a village anymore. We almost don't exist. What do you mean? This is pretty much a non-place, she grins. A gap. A blank spot on the map. Just a cluster of nameless shacks on a nameless street. Conceptualization says the place is so pornographically poor it's not even funny. I think I'll tell an old lady that. There's gotta be something here, tell me. She waves her hand southwest. Over there you can find more of the same. Shacks and trees growing wild. That's the pox. The pox? What's that? An old military hospital in its surroundings. She looks towards the buildings to the south, where it used to be during the time of the suzerain. After the war, it was turned into a goodwill hospital for shell shock veterans and folks looking for some quiet in the old sanatorium gardens. Now the area is crisscrossed with nameless streets and makeshift cinder block houses, Shacks as far as the eye can see. What happened to the hospital? The Goodwill ran out. She tightens the scarf around her neck. The staff left and the place was shut down. It's long gone by now. Who lives in this village? Well, there's Lilienne and her kids. Lilienne's twin. Do you name her kids after her? Both of them? A few new folks live in the house to the east. She nods her head across the courtyard. But they're away right now. Okay, Lilienne's twin, meaning twin in place of child. I think I get it. Not as actual, you know, when you talk about someone's twin, you're usually talking about the other twin, not the parent. And then there's the drunks. Not a pretty sight, but there's little we can do about it. Home is home, even for them. Who? What drunks? Sooner or later you'll see for yourself. She slowly shakes her head. Don't have to look long to find these guys. I think they're over that way. Is there a way to make a little money around here? Here? For you? She lets out a dry chortle. No, officer. The only money we have here is some coins the drunks tried hiding from their women and then forgot about. All right, there's another topic I'd like to address. She nods, rinsing another piece of cloth. What's further down the coast? Not much, she replies and wipes her forehead. There's the abandoned church, the DeLorean Church of Humanity. It's been there since before my time, even. Why is it abandoned? Some things just don't fly, officer. She smiles a gap-toothed smile and smells the air. Look around. Who'd go to church here? They built it 300 years ago. Must have been nicer then. Kim says, so they don't hold services there anymore? The ecclesiasts? No, they've tried, but things just keep happening. Crime, accidents, other things. The place never stays open, she frowns. It's a pity. It used to be such a nice church. Empathy says, she's not telling you all she knows. Keep her talking. I get the feeling you're leaving stuff out. What else is going on? Well, there's that music. Music from across the sea, she scoffs. It started a few days ago, and now it's blasting, even through the nights. And now, suspicious-looking people are sneaking around the church. I don't like that. Logic says, interesting. You could look into this ruckus, if you have the time. I hope we do. What else is on down coast? Before you go to the church, there's some ruins, an apartment complex, or some kind of electrical plant. Run-down bunch of houses, empty. Which is it, then? Apartments or electrical plant? I don't know exactly. A pre-war place. It used to be something. She shrugs. Before the war. I wasn't here then, you know. Was born in Samara. Anything else of note? Of note? The old fish market up on the boardwalk. But it's closed. Who'd want to come to a fish market here? No one. That's why it's closed. After a long pause, she adds, it was once a bustling place, back when I was young, and so was everyone else. Now, what catch we do bring in goes straight into a lorry for the Delta, or somewhere else. That's it? There's got to be more along the coast. What? You're one of those real estate people with big plans? If you want a development opportunity, you can check out the abandoned building over at Land's End. Used to be a supply depot, we think, sending goods and ammo across the bay. It's jammed shut, though. We tried to get in, see if there was anything to sell or scavenge, but it's impossible. She drops a bar of soap into the bucket with a splash. And now you know everything there is to know about the coast. This coast. Tell me about yourself. Who exactly are you here? Me? No one. Just an old washerwoman. Mother called me Isabel, if that's what you're saying. And my married name is Sadie. Now it's your turn, mister. Call me Harry. Why, I guess I will. Harry. Aye, it just rolls off the tongue. I used to know a Harry. Strong lad, but dumb as a rock. What happened to him? He did too many narcotics. So many he fell off his boat and split his skull on a buoy. She rubs soap off her hands. Folks who saw it say his head cracked open like a melly. A melon. Nasty, nasty. Where could someone stay around here? Stay? Most people here are trying to leave. That said, if lodgings is what you're looking for, I've got a free room in the shack. Her soapy thumb points to the building behind her. A free room as in empty, or free as in it doesn't cost anything? How much is it? I won't charge you for it. Take it as a gesture of goodwill from the village to the RCM. She did mean free. Wait, hold on. You're just giving it to me? No one is using it, and God knows it's not much anyway. She tilts her head on a side, pondering over something. You can stay there. There's this guy, Gart, who makes me give him money every night, just so I don't die out in the cold. Mm-hmm. That's exactly how they get you. That's why we built our own cinder block houses on the seaside, so we don't have to give money to those crooks. She looks around. They might not look like much, but they're ours. Wait, why isn't anyone using the room? My kids grew up and left, like they do. The house is long empty now. I live in a small side attachment. It's easier and cheaper to keep warm. Yeah, you've got yourself a tenant. Wow, we're gonna stay here, okay. Don't make an old woman regret giving her house to the police. A key appears from under her apron. She hands it to you. Kim says, well, if you're not in the hostel in the morning, I'll know where to find you. He looks around and adds, here, in a shack. You're definitely going to find me there, Kim. Empathy says, he's a little relieved you're no longer in that room. Okay. Sweet. I guess this is the place. 50 real. You can't see into the house from this angle. Inside, you hear the cozy sound of some kind of heater sputtering. The door has seen better days. The layer of paint has started to peel off due to the salt and wind from the sea. Even the lock looks slightly rusted. Oh, should I look at this key? Hold on a second. Or is it just an automatic thing? Keys. Okay, just list keys. Key to room 1, key to apartment building, key to shack on the coast. Okay. Kim says, I'll wait outside to give you some time and privacy to check out your new living arrangement, but just so you'd know, after we're done with the day, I'll still be staying in the Whirling at Rags for the night. We'll meet in front of the shack in the morning. The key turns with a satisfying click. You can enter the shack now. Yeah, I didn't want you to stay here with me. It's probably too small for both of us, Kim. Old science fiction magazines, books about bird watching, an almanac from 39. The floorboards creak under your step. This intricate heat engine hums quietly, giving out pleasant warmth. At least we have pleasant warmth. You see the waves? The sea? A church. Oh, a mirror. Yeah, same thing. The expression. I can't mess with it again yet. I'm not going to sleep yet, so I'm not going to click that. Alright, I'm done looking around. That's cool. Alright, what else is around here? There's a man. There's stuff over here. What are these doing in the fish? What are these? Franco-Nigerian cavalry boots, plus one perception. Huh. good old calf-length cavalry boots. Mount that horse and ride into the night. The heel comes in handy, too. It definitely... Let's say, haven't seen the RCM around for ages. It definitely makes you some good 5 centimeters taller, but it could be that it's also making you sharper, more perceptive to your surroundings, now that you've gained a new perspective? Yeah, it could. It would, if you put it on. So this gives us +1 composure, but -1 savoir faire. Let's put the boots on, because they don't give us minus to anything. It'll help with our perception. What's in the bucket? Tear.
Aye, officer.
Oh, Lilienne, the net picker. A woman in a raincoat stands on the quay, considering an overturned boat. A sword and a scabbard hangs from her hip.
Anything I can help you with?
That depends. Where are we exactly?
A fishing village on the seashore. This place doesn't really have a name. It's sometimes called Elysible.
Why?
The sign on the street leading here is illegible. Has been since they built this place.
The wind rattles her earrings. I've got some questions. The first is, what's your name?
The name is Lilian. People call me Netpicker. I think I have time for questions, and that was actually the second one.
She gestures towards the fishnets. Logic says, indeed, you're always confused as to your whereabouts. Suggestion says, ask her about the cool sword. Helps to break the ice. Nice sword. Does it come with a story? Unfortunately, the factory sold this one with a 3-year warranty instead of a story. She smiles at her own joke. It's to intimidate folks, mostly. It is imposing, nodding. It's a regular mass-produced sword, like a shovel or an axe. Nothing fancy. Just for intimidation. Why do you need intimidation tactics? From time to time, people need a lesson in respect. That's just the way it is. Back in the day, I caught the eyes of many men, and believe me, she adds, tittering, men need a lesson in manners from time to time. Why don't more women arm themselves if it's so effective? What makes you think we haven't? She smiles. Heh, the truth is that almost everyone in this life is scared and tired and stupid and too dull for that. That goes for men, too, but they put on an act for us, pretend like everything's good and living and crap doesn't bother them. Like anyone falls for that. True, most people I've met are scared. Aye, no one wants to talk about how frightened they are, but only frightened people are really dangerous, and plenty of them are dangerous. Can I borrow that sword? No, I'm afraid not. Her eyes are smiling as her hand moves to the hilt. Attempting to confiscate the blade I used to keep these animals in check? You would put me in an early grave. So where are all the men now? Some went to patch their wounds, their lesson learned. Others are more thick-headed. She looks down. And one of them I ended up marrying. Where's your husband now? Gone. Gone where? To the waves. Her eyes stop in yours. The sea took him. It was a long time ago. That's bad. What happened? Who knows? Maybe he fell over. She shrugs. He didn't respect the sea. Went out there drunk like a skunk. And sure enough, one day the boat was found floating empty. The bloated corpse turned up 2 weeks later. Now, before you tell me how sorry you are for my loss, know that it was 4 years ago, and I've moved on. There's only so much mourning you can do for a drunk with sinewy muscles. On death, okay. Should have thrown yourself... No. That's a stupid thing to say. It's healthy to let go and move on. Gotta keep the wheels spinning. Us working folk don't have the luxury to be bedsick with melancholy. She crosses her arms. I buried him, mourned for an appropriate amount of time, and went on. She glances at the village where two little kids are playing with what look like rocks. They are rocks. Life didn't really change that much for me and the kids. Empathy says this is neither a touchy nor a very interesting topic for her. Electrochemistry says she looks like she's ready to go on a date with another, better drunk. Ask her. Both of you could need some action. Really? This is very low, though. I'm not even sure of that. Looking for someone. What do you do around here? Like I said, fish, mostly. Sail the waves. Take care of the kids. Pick nets. Right now, I'm tarring a little skiff. Alright, by talking to her, I might be able to improve the chances of that. We got a plus one or something. Is that enough to make a living? Sometimes I also walk the beach to see what the sea has given up. The sea is full of surprises. Rhetoric says, keep it professional, man. Don't make it sound like you're hitting on her. Okay. So, ask her out, but keep it professional. Rhetoric and electrochemistry, you two need to, like, duke it out or something. Interesting. What have you found? Wood. Pieces of glass. Every once in a while we see dead bodies. Human, animal, fish. Other odd sea creatures. A mine washed ashore once. She looks at the beach and continues. Bottles. Jugs also. Lost cargo in general, but most of the time it's just wood and glass. Rhetoric says, all right, major choice moment. You only get to ask one thing. It would be weird to say them all. Choose wisely. Major choice moment? Major Norak, point to yourself. Nah. What does it matter? Human bodies doesn't sound like recently. The mine. Could we use a mine? Okay, a mine. The RCM could use a mine. Where is it? Well, the RCM has to wait for another one, because some army folks came by, took it in the middle of the bay, and blew it up. She spits over the railing. The blast was surprisingly timid for such a huge, spiky thing. Spiky, interfacing says. Must have been a naval contact mine. So I take it that's your skiff? Sure is. The Sun, I call her. Coated with a fresh layer of tar just yesterday. It'll take some time for it to dry, assuming the sunny days continue. Still very low. I'm looking for someone. Maybe you can help? Let's see. She tilts her head ever so slightly. Who are you looking for? Oh, yeah. I'm looking for both of them, actually. I'm looking for missing cryptozoologists. Ugh. She frowns, thinking, I don't think I know what these are. Care to elaborate? People who look for animals that mainstream scientists deny exist. Aha! She exclaims. Like snowmen? Snowmen. I haven't heard about those. Two odd guys have been wandering around here, nose in sand, talking nonsense about snowmen and the like. Wait, the like? Right, she nods. Not only snowmen, also green men, monkey men, burning rhinos. You get the picture. Conceptualization says, oh, you're getting it, and it is gorgeous. Where did they go? I don't really know. Further down the peninsula, I guess. I mean, that's where they were heading. She points north. Who else are you looking for, besides snowmen? A working-class husband. Yeah, I'm not really looking for that anymore. Not much into the middle-class ones, either. I could use some landed gentry, but apparently they don't make those anymore. The husband isn't for me. I'm looking for him for his wife. Wish I could help you with that, but I haven't seen your working-class husband. Maybe I can help you find someone else? Let's see, I'm not looking for anyone else right now. Empathy says she seems genuinely sorry for not being able to help you. Well, how can I assist you then, officer? I might come back to her, because I'm very low. Kim's present makes it awkward. Oh, negative 6, look at that. Don't know a good spot yet, explore the coast. Then we can go on a date. Then we get... Well, not really plus 6 to it, but 0 instead of minus 6. Be seeing you. What we got in here? 70 more. Hey kids! Oh, never mind. The boat is floating freely in the water, unmoored. The ladder leads to a school of fish swimming in the kelp. I feel like I got something else. Alright. Well, I'll call it an episode here, and we'll explore these fishing villages some more next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.